Check it out, man. Picked up a little toolkit. Rhyobi one. Couldn't pass it up, man. I talked the guy down at Home Depot to $149 for all this. It was originally $179 plus tax. Look at all this, man. You get a half, not three, it's half inch. Drill driver, two-speed gearbox, saws all, reciprocating saw, circular saw. You also get a flashlight, carrying case, two lithium batteries, teleport charger. This thing's good. You can use over 70 different tools with this particular kit right here. We're going to do an unboxing here in a little while. But check it out, man. 24-position clutch, two-speed gearbox, half-inch heavy-duty single-sleeve keyless chuck. Anyway, reciprocating saw, you get your sawzall, toolless blade clamp for quick and easy blade changes, variable speed for cutting all materials. Variable speed, huh? Grips in a mold, but drill driver, 1600 RPMs, half-inch. There's your charger there, circular saw, work light. Anyway, it's got it all, man. Big heavy box. It's that Rhyobi one you keep seeing advertised on Home Depot commercials, man. Oh, yeah, we'll do a nice little unboxing of this later on. Super combo kit. Oh, yeah. Okay, let's open this bad boy up, see what we got, man. What's this? Duffel bag? Oh, it all comes in a carrying case. What? Look at this. Rhyobi. Oh, that's sweet. It comes with its own gigantic duffel bag. What? I guess all the goodies are inside, man. How am I going to unzip this and hold the camera at the same time? Oh, man. Here we go. Here we go. Ah, here we go. There's the goods. Holy moly. Guacamole. There's the goodies. All right, man. Rhyobi niche. Okay, there's your sawzall. Your reciprocating blades. Looks like they give you a wood one and a metal one. There's your saw blade. Okay, that's the 5 1/4 inch whatever. Instructions. All that stuff there. This looks like a charger. Okay. Here's your charger. Okay. Batteries. Okay. It says it came with two batteries. It does. These are the batteries for it. Two batteries. Okay. All right. What do we got here? This looks like the sawzall. Yep. This is your sawzall, your reciprocating saw. What thing is it? It says it weighs about 3.5 pounds. It does. I can tell. Well, it's going to be fun ripping some lumber with this bad boy. But here's your sawzall. Okay, here is the circular saw. There we go. Circular saw. Got your angles there, your measurements. Trigger lock. Okay. And here's the drill. All right, here's the drill. Looks like it's okay. It comes with a little bit kit in here. There we go. Of course, it ain't gonna work. There's no battery in it. But, yep, 24 position. Here's your drill position there. Half inch keyless chuck. Yeah, this gives you some standard bits, it looks like. A couple of standard bits. That's no big deal. I got plenty of bits. And the thing here is the flashlight. Okay. All right. Looks like an LED. Actually, it doesn't look like an LED. It looks like an incandescent type bulb. I'll have to look into that, but no big deal. I didn't buy it for the flashlight. Nobody buys the kits for the flashlight. And this works with 70 different tools, man. Anyway, just a little quick unboxing for you guys. $149. You know. Big old charger, though. Man, that thing is beefy. Big beefy charger. Power on, testing, defective, charging, charge. Shows your different modes and all that. I like the fact that the batteries work with everything. So, quick little recap. There's your trigger. Looks like that's your trigger lock. Anyway. Saw, the drill, the batteries. Flashlight. Extra battery, big duffel bag carrying case. Heavy duty. This thing's really strong, man. Real heavy duty. But yeah, there you go, man. And like I said here, they give you a couple starter blades. Blades are pretty universal and cheap. And not bad at all, man. $149. Everything battery operated. 18 volt. Nice. Got everything back in here. Check this out, man. You put this battery in here. It's got a real nice click to it. Watch this. Ready? Got a good click. So you know it's in there. Cool. We're going to get these batteries charged up and make a few test cuts and drill a few holes. Future video coming later. Next couple days, maybe. Or when I get around to it. Check it out. It's one of the tools in this brand new kit I got. That Rhyobi Sawzall. Got a wood blade on there. I already tested the thing out, man. I think cuts pretty good. Cuts real good, actually, man. I like this thing here. No tool blade change. You just pop this here. Lift this out. Right here. Lift it over. Pop the blade in. Press it closed. 18 volt lithium ion. And this is variable speed, man. Check, this is crazy, man. Variable speed, watch. See, look. Go slow. Or you can go fast. This thing's a beast, man. It works so good. Something to cut down for you. Tell you what, let's go here. We'll cut a little branch off here. Now, this is not the pruning blade. It's like an all-around wood, like 2x4 blade. We're going to get a pruning blade one of these days. And like a demolition blade. Let's see. Let's find something to cut. They got demolition blades, pruning blades, specialty blades. Let's see. We'll cut this. This is a nice big one here. But, let's see, ready? Look at that clean cut, man. Nice clean cut. Pretty cool, man. I'm gonna have a, this thing's gonna get a lot of use, man. A lot of use. Okay, so for blade change, you pull this over here, open that up, and then the blade slides right in. I'm going to try to do this one-handed here. Yeah, that's not going to work. Let's see. Oh, I wish I could find my damn tripod. Huh, it worked. It actually worked one-handed. Now tell me that ain't awesome. If you chop one of your hands off, you can still operate this thing and change blades with one hand. I can't believe I just did that. Little, it's so easy, man. That is so easy. Change blades again. You just pop that open. Blade falls right out. So you can actually set the blade on top of this thing. Take one finger, pop this open, like so, and let go. See, you just go like that. The blade falls into place. And you just let go, and then your blade's secured. Now I got the metal blade in here now, so we're gonna find a metal pipe or something to cut up. Putting it through its paces here. I still can't get over the variable speed on this thing. Look how slow you can go. I've never seen this on a sawzall. Let's see, we turn it on here. Look at how slow you can go. Talk about precision cuts. I like this thing, man. Variable speed on a sawzall. What? Okay, we're back. We're going to cut. We tried this out, this Rhyobi 18-volt lithium ion sawzall on wood. It worked good. We're going to try it on metal now. I got a real thin-walled metal pipe. What I like about this sawzall is it's got a real short stroke on the reciprocating. So if you're doing something close to the ground, like, you know, like I've seen those like Milwaukee tools, they get the really, really long blades. If you're doing something close to the ground, that thing's moving 3,100 RPMs or whatever. And you hit the tip of that on concrete, you just snap the blade right off. This got a shorter stroke. Anyway, let's... another thing, when you're using, if you've never used a sawzall, a reciprocating saw before, you want to, when you're cutting metal or wood, you want to get it as close to you down here as possible. Same thing with a chainsaw. And you don't want to have your material that you're cutting too far out. Like if I went way out here, and then tried to cut it here, there would be so much vibration coming off here. So when you're using a sawzall, you want to keep it as short as possible to what you're cutting. So that looks about right. I'm going to put my foot on here, and we'll do a little test cut here with this Rhyobi here. Look, sort of, this one here is the P515. P515, 3,100 strokes a minute. Okay, P515, metal test. Okay, here we go. Oh, cuts it right off, smooth. See that again, man, that was pretty smooth. Ready? Oh, wow, that's quick. Now, I know this ain't like a natural gas pipe or nothing, but that's a nice smooth cut for it. So, yeah, all in all, man, it cuts wood, it cuts metal. I like it. This is a Rhyobi lithium ion. I'll be reviewing more tools from the kit that I got soon. This is just one. I got the circular saw, the flashlight. The flashlight, and I got the nice drill, 24 position clutch, nice little drill. So anyway, that's a little test for you guys. Hope you liked the video. Rate, subscribe, like. More videos like this coming. I'll be reviewing the circular saw and the drill pretty soon in future videos. Okay, here's all the Rhyobi tools. All laid out. Got your sawzall. Variable speed. Quick blade change. 24 position clutch. drill, circular saw over here, and you got the flashlight here with the adjustable head on it. You can rotate the entire flashlight here, and pretty cool, man. They all take the same battery, the 18-volt lithium ion 18s. And I love this, man, the circular saw. You got your the wrench for it stores right in there in the case. How about that? It's not going to come out, but reviews are coming. Okay, this is the Rhyobi drill, part of the tools that I got with the Rhyobi kit. And show you guys what's going on with this thing. It's the P271. Right off the bat, I'll show you guys, it's got a level on there. See that? You got your level on there. You have your 1 and 2, your torque settings. Right here, so you can slide it down position 1 or position 2. See that? It's got a 24 position clutch on it. You got your trigger lock right here. You can turn this all the way up to drill setting. Extremely hard to do with one hand. See, hang on, bear with me here. Here's your drill setting right here. So you want to put it on like the torque setting on 1 and turn this all the way around. If you're doing drilling, you can rotate it all, you know, or if you're just driving drywall screws in, you want to, you know, use the appropriate settings so it doesn't dry it all the way through the drywall. I like this. It's a half inch instead of 3/8, so you can put the bigger drill bits in there. Keyless chuck, of course. No need to show you how that operates. You just hold the thing and pull the trigger, and it'll open and close. Keyless chuck. But yeah, got the plenty of speed on there. That thing, but takes the 18 volt just like all the other Rhyobi tools. The 18 plus lithium ion battery, and I like it. It's got a good feel. Good hard impact plastic. If you drop it, it's not going to break. And at the same time, the areas where you're going to be using the tool, which is a nice rubber armor, it's got a good feel, nice, good, well balanced, good solid feel to it. I could use, it's not too heavy. I could use this all day. I could use this all day without getting fatigued. You know, of course, if the battery's hold up, that's obvious. See, there's your variable speed. We can go full blast. So yeah, this is the Rhyobi right here, 18V. Keyless chuck, 24 positions, and I like it. Got a good weight to it, good feel. Like I said, very well balanced, ergonomic. Anyway, that's that. There'll be more reviews. I don't think I need to demo them. You guys know what it looks like to put a bit in here and drill through a piece of wood. It's kind of boring, but it's a drill. It drills holes. It's pretty much, or you can put other stuff in there, of course. You know, hole cutters, attachments, auger bits, that kind of stuff. But it's pretty straightforward, that stuff is. So I'm just reviewing on what I see here. The feel, the look, the build quality, the power. Variable speed works, and it's got the level on there, which I like. Pretty cool, man. Plenty of vents to keep it ventilated there so it doesn't heat up on you. So anyway, that's that.